Someone is trying to kill me. I'm not who you think I am. Look! See?
The Duke's a duchess?
Huh? Not exactly.
Whoa, that's a lot of guys.
Don't be alarmed. This is a misunderstanding. I am sure we can reach an agreement without further bloodshed.
You've got my attention.
The impersonator you've been chasing is Lady Muriel Corwin, the Duke's sister. If you want to see the Duke, you need only look there. The real Duke Corwin died almost a month ago while visiting to negotiate a treaty. Even using Colto suspension, our attempts to revive him have ultimately failed. All we've managed to do is delay his bodily death.
Doesn't explain why you've got his sister running around as a decoy.
Duke Corwin promised he'd rally nobles loyal to him to Organa's side. But his death dashed any hopes of those alliances. Lady Corwin agreed to help us and her. Strong family resemblance allowed her to make a convincing double for her brother.
She does kind of have a case of the howling uglies.
We sent her to House Rist to maintain the illusion that the Durasteel Duke was alive and well until she finished negotiating those alliances.
You may as well have put a blaster to her head yourself.
We never imagined someone could harm her while under the protection of House Rist. Since you're more than capable of taking Duke Corwin from us, we won't resist under two conditions. Leave peacefully and speak nothing of this deception to anyone.
Looks like we're finally catching a lucky break.
Will you agree to those terms?
Lady, I'm getting paid by the corpse. Unless you've got a better offer.
Take this, then. It's half of what I will send you, provided I never see you again. He's yours, Bounty Hunter. Just go in peace.
Goodbye, brother. You make sure he gets a proper burial.
Okay.
Tell the Huntmaster he was already dead. They might make us do another one. right behind you.
This is a new low, Rafid.
You're accusing me. If anyone is...
Gentlemen, compose yourselves. Our esteemed guest has returned.
We are busy, bounty hunter, and as you can see, Baron Zakhar is otherwise indisposed. My nephew's last act was preparing a sum of credits. I can only assume they're yours.
How'd the Baron bite it?
My nephew was done in by a poisoned glass of wine. Obviously his overambitious progeny's doing.
I'm ambitious now? Why, Uncle, stooping to compliments to slander me.
The Baron has no further need of your services. I have to assume the burden of managing my nephew's estate.
As the Baron's only son, I have first claim to succession, Hader.
Your claim was forfeit the moment you killed your father. As regent, the title passes to me.
Actually, Father, the Baron passed his authority to our advocate. Legally, the bounty hunter could name the new head of House Gerard.
That'll be whichever one of you makes this worth my while.
I've accumulated a tidy sum over the years. Appoint me Baron, and I'll see you well rewarded.
Ha! Hader keeps his purse strings so tight he could garrot you with it. Now you look radiant with the blush of power. Ever considered becoming a baroness?
Should either one of them take over, we'll all end up paupers or lapdogs to the Thules. If you would finally liberate me from these buffoons, I would be very grateful.
Enough pandering. What's your decision, Advocate?
I'm going with Itala.
Father, I shan't have need of your counsel as Vice Baron. You may consider yourself a lord-in-waiting.
This is your gratitude for rearing you to adulthood?
Think of it as a reward for all the years you devoted to raising me as a commodity. As for you, Rafid, you are hereby banished from House Gerard.
What? You can't! Where will I go?
When have you ever had trouble finding a bed? I'm sure you'll be fine. I can handle things from here, Advocate. Thanks to you, I can now take control of my life. She could use an attitude adjustment, but Itala wasn't that bad in the end.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
wrist flunky dead ahead. Better watch your back.
You looking for trouble?
No need to be alarmed. I'm only here to deliver a message. It is unfortunate that our individual arrangements had us at odds earlier, but that's simply the nature of our business. My master wishes to ensure that there's no ill will left between us.
Since you asked so nicely, I'll consider it.
Please do. Hostilities between us would be an unnecessary expense for everyone involved. House Rest will no longer interfere with your affairs. News Taro Blood will not take graciously, I'm sure. He fronted a considerable sum to ensure his rivals were dealt with. I imagine he'll threaten some reprisal, but I think we both know what Taro Blood's word is worth.
Good day to you. I bring the good wishes of Moff Sarek, the officer entrusted with annexing this planet. He has been anticipating your arrival.
Either I'm moving up in the world, or there are people he wants dead.
Knowing the Moff, sir, I would guess more than a few.
Good day! You have served us before, have you not? A valuable hire. I expect you care little for the niceties of politics here, so I will be brief. The Empire intends to use Alderaan's succession struggle to bring it into the fold, and I'm offering you the opportunity to play a pivotal role.
Is this a job interview, then?
Oh, you have the job, if you're willing. We would not be speaking otherwise. The heir to Alderaan's throne was recently assassinated, right after withdrawing from the protection of the Republic. The planet's in civil war, and for the first time in thousands of years, without the armies of the Republic to bring order.
That's a long time. Has the Republic really given them up?
The Republic has its proxies here, as we have ours. We have allied ourselves with House Thull. The House was exiled 60 years ago after a failed bid for power, and came to us instead. Unfortunately, they have proven too weak to do what's needed.
You got someone they're not killing for you?
Yes. But Thull must also learn what it means to be an arm of the Empire. Jorand, one of the Thull lords, insists on following Alderaan's rules of civilized warfare. I want you to show him warfare is far from civil. Several of Thull's vassal houses, Thull's connection to us became public. This cannot be allowed. Take a slave collar from...
They will learn that the best way to survive...
These lords of Alderaan must lose.
Lady's sidekick, Buster.
Crymar! Is that Crymar Noven? That's a free nobleman of Alderaan. Unhand him. Who are you? What's this about?
Keep them from rebelling, and the Empire will not have to punish them.
All of Alderaan will be thrown into chains because of you!
Silence, slave. The sooner you see reason.
I'm not certain that someone of your profession should make this sort
of... I make this decision.
Sir.
Thule vassals will now think twice about rebelling.
Excellent. I am pleased with your work. Very pleased. I would like to offer you a commission. Be my representative in House Thule. Aid Jorad and his men, and obey her as you would me. And with the same penalty for defiance. Tell her what must be done to secure
Yes, sir. My lady.
What's the next step?
I suppose the Moff expects us to take on House Organa. They're one of our oldest noble houses, and until recently they've been without an army, but they've got support.
You'll never find them. They've got top-of-the-line cloaking, better than anything the Empire makes. No probes will get through, no spy sats, nothing.
I'm smarter than a probe droid.
House Organa denied raising an army, claiming it's just patriots defending their lands. But they're attacked. We'll never find every group. We need to get inside their planet-wide communications, and that means finding a base with a physical link to slice into.
Whatever, I'm on the clock.
How can you destroy the culture of an entire world and call it a mere day of work?
Silence! If you stand with the Organas, you betray 1,000 years of loyalty. The Organa guerrillas have a base hidden in some cave or other natural camouflage. There should be a master comlink there, guarded by their best soldiers. If you insert this computer spike, it'll give us a back door into all their communications.
Once we can hear them, there's nowhere on this world they'll be safe.
House Organa will not make another move without us knowing.